So today we are going to study Leopold von Ranke, another European scholar, 1795 to 1886. Historiography of the 19th century was greatly influenced by the thoughts of Leopold von Ranke of Berlin University. So this philosopher was from Berlin University, and the historiography of the 19th century was greatly influenced. He had a great influence on the historiography of the 19th century. Actually, he spoke about the critical method of historical research, and he put emphasis on the utmost importance of information gathered through original documents. Leopold von Ranke thought the historical research should be done with the critical method, and the information that is gathered, that is collected, should be collected through the original documents with the critical method. So ये believe करते थे कि critical method का use करके original documents से ही information collect करनी चाहिए, ऐसा वो मानते थे. So according to Leopold von Ranke, critical method of historical research should be done, and the information that is collected should be collected from the original documents. While doing this, while handling, he also stated that all type of documents associated with the historical events need to be examined with greatest care. Means whatever the documents are over there that a scholar or a historian is dealing with them, he is studying, he is doing historical research that are associated or related with the historical events, they must be handled, they must be examined with greatest care, lot of care. Means carefully we have to examine the historical documents with critical method. क्रिटिकल एग्जामिनेशन के साथ में हमने ओरिजिनल डॉक्यूमेंट्स को, जो हिस्टोरिकल इवेंट से रिलेटेड है, इनको बहुत ही केयरफुली हमने इनका एग्जामिनेशन करना चाहिए. ही बिलीव दैट विद दिस मेथड इट वाज पॉसिबल टू रीच द हिस्टोरिकल ट्रुथ. और वो ऐसा मानते थे, ही बिलीव्ड दैट इफ वी डू द क्रिटिकल हिस्टोरिकल रिसर्च with the help of original documents related to the historical events, that will help us to reach to the historical truth if we examine them with great care. And that's why he criticized imaginative narration of history. He believed that ki historical narration karte samay imaginations nahi hona chahiye. So there is no space for the imaginative writing of history. So he criticized on the imaginative narration of the history. His articles were published, collection of his articles were published in two books. First, Theory of Practice of History, the Theory and Practice of History, and the second one is The Secret of World History. Another scholar of the Europe is Karl Marx, 1818 to 1883. He is well known because of his opinions, because of his views, philosophy. Russia revolted, means the revolution took place in Russia. In the latter half of the 19th century, a new school of thought arose, keeping in view the new thesis formulated by Karl Marx. So in the latter of the 19th century, a new school of thoughts arose in Europe, keeping in view, means with the Karl Marx, it helped to rise this new school of thought because of the views by Karl Marx. So in the latter half of the 19th century, a new school of thoughts, people started thinking differently, means because of the Karl Marx views affected this group of people, those believed on his views. So latter half of the 19th century mein Karl Marx ke views wala ek naya group emerged hua Europe mein. According to Karl Marx, history was not about abstract idea, it was about living people. एब्स्ट्रैक्ट आइडिया, हिस्ट्री कोई एब्स्ट्रैक्ट आइडिया नहीं थी कार्ल मार्क्स के हिसाब से, मीन्स अमूर्त रूप नहीं था, कोई इमेजिनेशन नहीं था, ओके, इट वॉज नॉट एब्स्ट्रैक्ट आइडिया, बट इट वॉज अबाउट द जीते जाते लोगों के बारे में हिस्ट्री थी, इट इज अबाउट लिविंग पीपल, सो इट मस्ट बी केयरफुली डन द हिस्टोरिकल रिसर्च. अकॉर्डिंग टू कार्ल मार्क्स, ह्यूमन रिलेशनशिप्स आर शेप्ड, आर फॉर्म्ड बाय द फंडामेंटल नीड्स ऑफ द पीपल एंड द ओनरशिप एज वेल एज द नेचर ऑफ द प्रिवेलेंट मीन्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन टू मीट दोज नीड्स. मीन्स ह्यूमन रिलेशनशिप ऐसी किस चीज से शेप की जाती है? फंडामेंटल नीड्स ऑफ द पीपल, लोगों की फंडामेंटल नीड्स एंड द ओनरशिप एंड नेचर ऑफ द मीन्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन, दोज अटेन, दोज फुलफिल दोज नीड्स. सो इन नीड्स को, फंडामेंटल नीड्स को पूरी करने वाली जो मीन्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन है, जो प्रिविलेंट है उस समय, प्रेजेंट है, उनका नेचर और उसकी ओनरशिप किसके पास में है, दैट शेप्स द ह्यूमन रिलेशनशिप. ह्यूमन रिलेशनशिप इस तरह से क्रिएट होते हैं कि लोगों की फंडामेंटल नीड्स क्या है और उसको पूरी करने वाले जो मीन्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन है वो उनका नेचर क्या है और वो किसके ओनरशिप में है, वो डिपेंड करता है कि ह्यूमन रिलेशनशिप कैसे हो. द एक्सेसिबिलिटी ऑफ दीज मीन्स टू डिफरेंट स्ट्रेटा ऑफ द सोसाइटी मे नॉट बी इक्वल. इट इज ट्रू, इट इज रियली ट्रू दैट एक्सेसिबिलिटी टू दीज मीन्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन to the different strata of the society, different parts of the society may not be equal. Ek jaisa nahi hoga. Every strata of the society could not access these means of production equally. Equally inko wo access nahi karte honge. There are two parts of the society, divisions in the society, haves and haves not. Haves means those who have the ownership of the means of productions, and haves not means those do not have the ownership of means of productions. So it is clear that haves would have the lot of opportunities to access the means of production and haves not do not have lot of opportunities to access the means of production. This inequality causes a division of the society into two classes. Because of this inequality of accessibility to the means of productions, created two divisions in the society, two classes in the society that leads to the class struggle. Okay, inequality ki wajah se society mein do classes, haves and haves not. Okay, do classes create ho gaye and that leads to the class struggle. Unke beech mein class struggle ho jayega, right? So according to Marx, human history is the history of class struggle, as the class that owns the means of production means haves, okay, economically exploits the rest of the classes. So according to Karl Marx, human history is the history of this class struggle. Equal accessibility नहीं है, so of course उनके दो classes के बीच में clashes होगे, struggle होगा, और according to Karl Marx यही class struggle, the history of class struggle is the human history. Yahi human history hai, because class that owns the means of production, jiske paas ownership hai, means the haves, they exploit the other, the rest of the class. Dusre class ko exploit karte, economically exploit karte hai. So Das Kapital, or TD, is written by him, is the most referred book all over the world. So his views, his treatise have been written in the book called Das Kapital. So इस book में, उनके इस book में, Das Kapital नाम की इस book में उनके वो views, उनकी philosophy इसमें लिखी हुई है, that is all over recognized. Annal School. At the onset of the 20th century, at the beginning of the 20th century, a new school of historiography arose in France, which is known as Annals School. So at the beginning of the 20th century, new school of thoughts, new school of historiography emerged in France, that is known as Annals School. So Annals School gave a new direction to history writing. Annals School ne new history writing mein ek nayi disha nikali. New directions has been given by the Annals School. It was recognized now that history is not only about the political events, kings, great leaders, and accordingly politics, diplomacy, and wars, but also about the climate, local people, agriculture, trade, technology, means of communication, social divisions, and their collective psychology, etc. in the historical times. So, annals could give new directions to the history writing. Hitherto, it was recognized. Hitherto, it was said that the history was written only about the political events, kings, great leaders, accordingly politics, and then diplomacy, wars, etc. इनके बारे में ही history लिखी जाती थी. But annals could said, annals could gave the new direction to the historiography. In not only we have to write about these things, political events, kings, great leaders, their politics, their diplomacy, and the wars, but also we have to write, we have to study while writing history, climate, local people, agriculture, their trade, technology, means of communication, what kind of social divisions and collective psychology, everything we have to study along with these things. So, ये भी हमने study करनी चाहिए. While writing history, we have to focus on these issues also. इन पर भी हमने ध्यान केंद्रित करना चाहिए in the historical time. Whatever the historical event we are going to study, we have to study all the aspects of the human life. The Annals School was started by the French historians. ये Annals School से ये French historians ने start किया था. Another thought, school of thought is feminist historiography. Feminist historiography कौन सी थी वहां पर देखते हैं. Feminism. Feminist historiography means the restructuring of the history from the perspective of women. Hitherto the history was mostly written by the male historians. It was only written about the males. So feminist historiography means it was the restructuring of the history ko restructure karna hai with the point of view of women ke point of view se history ko restructure karna hai. We have to restructure the history from the perspective of women. This is known as the feminist historiography. The writing of Simone de Beauvoir helped in establishing the fundamentals of feminism. So, one major personality historian, the writing of Simone de Beauvoir, her writings helped in establishing the fundamentals of feminism. Feminism kya hai, uske kya fundamentals hai, wo, because of the writings of Simone de Beauvoir, these fundamentals were formed. She was French. The feminist historiography emphasized not only on the inclusion of women in history, but also on the rethinking of the male-dominated perspective of history. This feminist historiography emphasizes not only on the inclusion of the women in the history. सिर्फ women को history में include करना इस पर emphasize नहीं करती है, but it emphasizes on the rethinking of the male-dominated perspective of history. Male-dominated perspective of history को हमने rethink करना चाहिए, सच में फिर से सोचना चाहिए. That where was the women's place in the history? We have to think about it. So ये हमने सोचना चाहिए. We have to include the women in history as well as we have to restructure, we have to rethink the male-dominated perspective of history. It drew historical research to focus in depth on various aspects of women's life, such as their employment, their role in trade union, institutions working for their cause, their family life, etc. Because of this feminist historiography, it drove the historical research, it gave a new direction to the historical research, it pulled the attraction of the historical research to focus on the depth on various aspects of women's life. Women's life के अलग-अलग aspects के बारे में उस पर focus करने के लिए historical research ने focus करना चाहिए. ये direction इस ओर historical research को खींचा गया because of the feminist historiography, because of the views of the feminist historiographers. So what kind of aspects of women life should be focused while writing the history? Their employments, their role in trade union institutions, working for their cause, then their family life, etc. Ye aspects of the women life should be focused by the historical research. So ye bhi aspects of human life, women's life soche jane chahiye, uske bare mein bhi while they should be regarded while narrating the historical research, while doing the historical research. In the historical writing after 1990, important point is this: in the historical writing after 1990, women were portrayed as an independent social class. Or after 1990, in historical writings, women were portrayed, displayed as an independent class. Unko ek independent class ki tarah treat kiya jane laga. Means they got the importance in historical writing after 1990. Michel Foucault, 1926 to 1984. The French historian of the 20th century, Michel Foucault, brought forth a new concept in historiography. So Michel Foucault, he was a French historian of the 20th century, and he brought a new concept in historiography. What is that? Let us see. In his book, Archaeology of Knowledge, what is the name of his book? Archaeology of Knowledge, argued that prevailing practice of arranging historical events in chronological order is not right. What did he, hum kya karte the? Historical events ko chronological order mein set karte the while writing the history. While in historiography, hum kya karte the? Chronological sequence arrange karte the historical events. But according to him, he said that this practice of arranging the historical event is not right. उन्होंने कहा कि ये historical arrangement हम जो करते हैं chronological वो सही नहीं है. He drew attention to the fact that archaeology does not strive to reach the ultimate historical truth, but attempts to explain various transitions in the past. So what did he try to do? That he drew attention of the scholars to the fact. इस fact के तरफ उन्होंने scholars का ध्यान खींचने की कोशिश की, that archaeology does not strive to reach the ultimate historical truth. Archaeology historical truth तक पहुंचने का के efforts नहीं लेती है, but attempts to explain various transitions in the past. So what does archaeology does? Archaeology tries to explain the various transitions in past. Past में होने वाले transitions को explain करने की कोशिश करती है, historical truth तक पहुंचने की कोशिश नहीं करती है. Foucault failed. Foucault failed that explaining the transitions in history is more important, and that's why he failed कि हमने historical events को chronologically order में arrange करने से ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट हिस्टोरिकल ट्रांजिशंस को एक्सप्लेन करना चाहिए. इट इज मोर इंपॉर्टेंट टू एक्सप्लेन द हिस्टोरिकल ट्रांजिशंस. ट्रांजिशंस इन हिस्ट्री में जो भी हुए हैं, दैट आर इंपॉर्टेंट, वो इंपॉर्टेंट है. दिस कॉल्ड हिज मेथड द आर्कियोलॉजी ऑफ नॉलेज, और दैट्स व्हाई ही कॉल्ड हिज मेथड द आर्कियोलॉजी ऑफ नॉलेज. और इसको वो अपने इस मेथड को आर्कियोलॉजी ऑफ नॉलेज कहते हैं. Foucault subjected the so far unacknowledged area of historians such as psychological disorders, science of medicine, prison administration, etc. to historical analysis. And in this way, Michel Foucault subjected the so far unacknowledged area where the historians or the scholars, the students of the histories did not focus, they did not concentrate on those areas, such areas he subjected, like psychological disorders, science of medicines, prison administration. These he brought these areas into his historical analysis. उन्होंने इन areas को अपने historical analysis में लाया. Thus the scope of historiography kept continuously expanding. और इस तरह से हिस्टोग्राफी का स्कोप जो है वो कंटिन्यूसली एक्सपैंडिंग होते रहता है, वो हमेशा बढ़ते रहता है. इट डज नॉट स्टॉप एट वन प्लेस. न्यू थिंग्स, न्यू एविडेंसेस, नई चीजें हमें पता चलती है, इसके स्कोप और आगे आगे बढ़ते चलते हैं. सो राइटिंग ऑफ हिस्ट्रीज ऑफ वेरियस सब्जेक्ट्स लाइक लिटरेचर, आर्किटेक्चर, स्कल्पचर, ड्रॉइंग एंड पेंटिंग, म्यूजिक, डांस, ड्रामा, फिल्म एंड टेलीविजन एक्सेट्रा केम इन टू प्रैक्टिस. एंड इन दिस वे ग्रेजुअली राइटिंग ऑफ हिस्ट्रीज ऑफ वेरियस सब्जेक्ट्स, इन सब्जेक्ट्स की हिस्ट्रीज भी हिस्टोग्राफी में आने लगी. सो ग्रेजुअली इट एक्सपैंडेड कंटिन्यूअसली, धीरे धीरे और हिस्टोग्राफी, द स्कोप ऑफ हिस्टोग्राफी और बढ़ते गया. लिटरेचर की हिस्टोग्राफी, आर्किटेक्चर की हिस्टोग्राफी, स्कल्पचर की हिस्टोग्राफी, है ना, हिस्ट्री, ये सारी हिस्ट्रीज, ड्रामा, फिल्म, डांस, टेलीविजन, ऑल द हिस्ट्रीज आर इंक्लूडेड इन द हिस्टोग्राफी. इन दिस वे द स्कोप ऑफ हिस्टोग्राफी कंटिन्यूअसली एक्सपैंडेड. सो thank you. Today we have finished the first chapter of history. Keep watching and don't forget to give me like, subscribe my channel and press bell icon so that my new upcoming video should reach you immediately. Thank you.